Previously on eFIXX, we reviewed this rather cool Milwaukee Force Logic hole punch. Well, today it's time to put it head to head with this Mandrex hole saw system.
That's like taking a Lamborghini on the school run. You can do it, but it's overkill.
Well, we don't know yet. I've set a little challenge up for us here. You know we like a challenge on eFIXX. You know, it could even be a race.
Well, I'd just like to stop you there. I know how this works before. I take it you're taking this one. I've got the old traditional method because I do like this Mandrex hole saws for electricians. But let's call it a review. And that means that we won't be sweating and rushing around as we punch these holes. I take it that it's going to have to come into this trunk kit.
Yeah. Well, okay. That's what you don't want to race. You know,
no,
you're confident in your own abilities.
Yeah. I know how this works. Yeah. I know how it works.
Okay. Well, we'll call it a review, but it's the same challenge. We've got set up in front of us, we've got to drill five holes, or you've got to drill five holes with your hole saw, 16 to 40 millimetres.
Okay, yeah, no problem.
And I'm going to punch. I'm going to smoothly punch with this cool tool five holes from 16 up to 40 millimetres.
Okay, that seems well within my comfort zone. And we're going to now review the Milwaukee Force Logic against the lovely electrician's kit from Mandrex. So first up, the Force Logic from Milwaukee, but I'm seeing a step cutter.
Yeah, because I've got to drill my pilot holes for the hole punch to work, Gary.
So that's one of the things I'm not seeing on many of the reviews that I've seen of this tool before. You have to drill a hole before you punch a hole.
Yeah, that's right. And obviously people are going to be watching this saying, well, why don't you just use the step cutter you've got there?
That wouldn't be a very good Milwaukee Force Logic review, though, would it?
No, it wouldn't, no. But yeah, you're right. People miss that out.
Okay, so there's your first one, and you're going to drill a 12 mil and a couple at 20
mil, yeah.
In order to facilitate these hole punches.
But I can drill them all at once, and that's what I'm going to do.
Okay, well, I'm just going to step over, and I'm going to just drill my first hole and make it a 16 mil hole.
Okay, well, you could have just used the step cutter for that.
I could have done, but that wouldn't have been a review of the Mandrex hole saws then, would it?
So you're going in with that, just put them into the drill. Yeah. Well, I've got a top tip for you, Gary. Yeah, you shouldn't have put that cooling gel on before you'd found the punched mark.
Oh, it's the first time I'd got hold of the cooling gel. You'd done the other reviews on it. I was desperate to use it. So you can see there my mandrel's going in, and that mandrel will remain on the hole saw for the entire time I cut these. So as I go through now, and then my 16 mil hole saw will cut a hole. So one action, really.
And you're saying that's complete then? Well, no, you're going back in again.
Well, no. Yeah, that's the initial hole.
So you've got two actions to do, and I've got two actions to do.
No one's winning that argument bar me. Okay, so as always, it's a slower speed. Now I'm on speed setting one, and I'm using the cooling gel in order to prolong the life of my cutting tool, as well as make a perfectly clean hole, is the thinking behind this. So it's not full trigger. We're not racing. We're trying to review these tools.
Yeah, it seems to be taking a long time, Gareth.
Well, when you do it correctly, it will do. Yeah, and you notice that the swarf is being held by the cooling gel as well. I remember being on site and being sprayed with very fine shards of red hot swarf, and I did holes at a faster speed.
Okay, you're in there, right. And yeah, so
you're still going.
Yeah, so I'm back in for those slightly larger pilot holes. I've marked my step cutter green and blue, so I know what that was. You can overshoot on a step cutter, and I wouldn't want that to happen because then I wouldn't get to use the cool tool that is the Force Logic.
So you're still drilling holes to punch holes.
Yeah, but once I get going with that Force Logic, you're gonna see some action then.
Oh, a bit of cooling gel. I think you're a little late with that one though, weren't you?
Yeah, it's smoking away. Yeah. Okay, I'm trying to make up for lost time here.
So that's 20 mil. So you've got two at 20 and three at 12.
Yeah, so just clear that away.
Okay.
And now I can start assembling the hole punch.
So that was a 12 mil hole. Just remind me of the size of hole you're going to punch out.
So now we're going to just go take that 12 mil up to 16 millimetres.
Oh, thankfully we've got the Force Logic from Milwaukee to make that hole at 16 mil.
Okay, I must admit, I don't know, it's probably one of the least used ones that are in the box of punches that come with this tool, but it's quick once I get going. So I've hitched up there with the ball grab.
This bit's cool though, isn't it?
Yeah, this bit is cool. This is the only bit you'd see on site.
Yeah, come in and watch me make a hole.
Yeah, there you go. Look at that. Yeah. Effortless. So now I've just got to remove the waste material from the punch and die set.
I wouldn't imagine if we had a 12 mil hole that we've got much when it's now 16.
Yeah, possibly see if we can find it. A slither of metal. There's one bit dropped out. You didn't see it there, did you?
Yeah, I did see it. And there comes the second bit, is it? Yeah, there they are. I'll find them in a minute. There they are. Yeah. Wow, so you've done the first one.
Yeah.
Right, well, I've changed over now my hole saw, and I'm now at 20 mil. Just move that block of wood. I tend to keep missing that.
Okay. So
exactly the same process.
Okay, apart from you following my top tip now, you're going to actually bring the cooling gel in a little bit later, are you?
Yeah, I just want to mix it up, really. You know, I mean, people don't want to see me doing it the same every time. Yeah. And again, just drill through and then cut my hole out. Nothing quite difficult about this, is there?
Yeah. Oh, there you go. Oh, you're back in.
And a slow speed. Of course, you know, I'm going to bring that cooling gel. Look at that. I've got two hands going now. Look at that.
Oh, like a potter's wheel.
So that will be a 16 and a 20 mil done for me. Exactly the same process.
Yeah. Two processes, really. A drill, the pilot hole, then a large
one. I'm not.
And again, you're done. Yeah, nice and slow.
Yeah, it is the trick to go slow. And yeah, I probably overdid the cooling gel a little, but that's the hole through.
Right, so I'm just doing my 20mm hole now, so I've got my punch in there, all assembled in. There you go, look a lot quicker, a lot smoother. You see, I'm not shaking around on the bench with a drill, I'm just calmly getting on with it.
It sounds like we're missing the step cutter action that we had just a few moments ago.
Yeah, but you might have the apprentice doing that, they just come in with a cool tool to finish the job off. Yeah, so just disassemble the punch and die assembly again. Just tap out the material a little bit more material I moved up top. Yeah.
Hid it in the trunking, I noticed. Now stepped up to my 32mm hole. So I've done a 25 off camera, and now I'm at 32, because this is the stage where you've got a larger hole, isn't it? You notice my kit, apart from a hole saw, is identical as I had before.
Okay, got there. You've got that cooling gel. Wow.
It drags it in, though. Look at that. Ah, yes. And again, I'm going a little bit slower again now. So I've got a larger size of hole saw, so I need to go slower in order to get that nice cut into the trunking. You know, often with full trigger speed too, aren't we? Trying to blast through.
You're desperate to just pull the trigger full.
I'm not. I'm not desperate at all. So just gently does it. You know, it's no smoking off mine.
Yeah. And I have noticed actually how the waste material just drops out the end. You get a lot of hole saws where they claim have a spring for sheet metal. It just doesn't seem like you need it here. So if you go on the right speed, the middle bit just drops out.
And you saw it again there. Mm. Yeah, it just drops through. Okay. So you're in your 20mm hole for your 32. 20mm hole. Right,
yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
So again, same thing. Just putting the die onto the bottom there. Bring it in. Just put the safety guard in so we don't... trap our fingers in there.
And the bit we all love, yeah, we could watch that all day long, couldn't we?
Yeah, that's it. It's nice. Just cool. Yeah, just takes it out there.
So, final one then. Yeah. So, I think we're up to 40mm now. I don't want to say it, but I will. I'm using exactly the same kit, apart from the fact I've clicked in.
Slipped there.
No, I've clicked in
skidding
my...
Skidding around. I've missed the hole again.
Yes, I've clicked in my 40mm hole saw into my Mandrex hole saw, yeah. And there we go.
What, more cooling gel?
I just like it. You know, I've sprayed it everywhere there, haven't I? So, yeah, so I've been at a festival there. Everybody got a bit in the audience. And through we go. Gently on the last bit. Speed was even slower. I think that's me done.
Okay, well, I've just got one more hole to do. And that's the 40mm. I must point out this tool will go up to 100mm hole size.
Okay. What size hole do you have to pre-drill for that? 99mm?
No, that's it. Once you're into that zone, it's only that 20mm hole, but look at that, we're done. That's a 40mm one. So just remove the swarf. Or waste from the punch and die set. Obviously, you always have to disassemble it because you've got to re-thread it through a pre-drilled pilot hole, Gary.
Yeah, okay. Which was the first bit of the presentation where you drilled five holes before you punched five holes. Yeah. And there's your waste material. Okay, I won again then.
Oh, there you go. I told you it was quicker.
It wasn't a race, it was a review, wasn't it? It was just a review. Hang on. You press that start button there, and I press that one over there, so that's my time. I won the race.
No, hold on, you said this wasn't a race. You were quite categoric at the start, this wasn't a race. You wanted to follow the manufacturer's instructions and just do everything by the book. You had the coolant gel, you weren't maxing out on the Makita. So, not a race, but, you know.
So I won the review.
Your way of doing it initially was faster than this way. Yeah.
Initially faster.
Yeah, Initially faster. Okay. We'll come on to that. What I really think we need to do now, guys, is just look at hole quality.
Okay.
Yeah, because I mean,
the which Mandrex... ones you've drilled 10? Hmm? Oh no, obviously the first five have disappeared,
well,
haven't they?
I drilled five.
Okay, so we're looking at punched holes, not your drilled ones.
Yeah, let's have a look at these punch holes compared to that. And the Mandrex does a good hole, but a punched hole, oh, they are smooth. I mean, that is, I would dare say you wouldn't even need a grommet on those. Controversial, but drop a comment on there, but they are,
you're not
going to damage any cables on those. They are, run my finger around there all day.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm not going to run my finger around there all day.
Well, but that's fine.
There is, on the top, it's a clean hole for a hole saw, fantastic job, but I would suggest that you're going to have to do just a little bit of deeper look at that. You see, I'm running my finger around there, I'm picking up bits.
I just need to wipe up really at the end.
Then I think, yeah, you need to do some de-burring on those holes.
Well, again, let's go back to the race that I won. Yeah, look at the time difference. Review.
It'd be another 5 minutes cleaning those up, I think, and we'll look at that. And then possibly also, let's just have a look at the old swarfometer.
Oh, right. Is that what these soup containers, pea and ham, are all about, are they?
Yeah, so you did, you've generated a lot more swarf, I suggest.
Do you think that's the real thing that's going to send people over the line to get the Force Logic from Milwaukee, is these two soup containers at the end? Do you think that'll be the one that sends them off to purchase?
Could be, but you know, it's a lot more coolant gel used there.
Let's leave you to decide. Yeah, thoughts below. We've used a step cutter. I'm sure there's already some comments gone in about the step cutter. We've used the lovely fine tooth electrician set from Mandrex, which I love, in order to drill these wonderful holes in less time than it took to use this Milwaukee Force Logic, which is slightly more expensive than this compact set of hole saws here from Mandrex, okay, that do lovely smooth holes. Do you agree?
We love the Mandrex hole saw, okay?
We do.
This looks cool.
Yeah, it does.
You know, if you're in the market to spend a lot of money on a hole punch, I mean, this looks good. And you know, you probably wouldn't use the 16mm one. You'd probably want to buy some additional punches that may push the price up a little bit more.
I like the 100mm one idea.
Yeah, and this stainless steel, we can talk about that. Check out the review we made on this tool if you haven't seen it. Share your comments on where you are using it.
Okay, or if you're not using it and you're using something, say, like this hole saw kit from Mandrex, designed for electricians, recommended by an electrician, that was considerably quicker than this one from Milwaukee, we'd also like to hear all of those comments below. And Gordon's got some, hang on, what's that mystery tool there you've brought out at the end? I was just kind of running to...
Well, I think catch up with Gary in our next video. Leave those comments. But in the next video, Gary... we'll be demonstrating how to deburr a hole with this Noga deburring tool, and I'll be watching him with, perhaps I might have a cup of coffee with another tool that you suggested wasn't quite up to par, but I will enjoy drinking a cup of coffee while Gary deburrs those holes.
We'll let your comments and thoughts below decide the argument that I've just won.
There's your deburrer.